Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Tuesday, August 3rd, 2010. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Before I get started, I'd like to request your feedback on this video. Please leave a comment when you're done watching, even if you just say hi or thanks. I would really appreciate that. Now I'd like to clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. And we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a 3-minute chart without indicators for the Euro-USD currency pair as that chart looked at 8:30 a.m. New York time on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform. At this point, the euro was basically unchanged from its London Open level, which I've labeled on the left-hand portion of the chart. However, it is worth noting that the path that the euro took over the past few hours to get here. I see multiple occasions, which I've just labeled with blue arrows, multiple occasions where the euro has respected its weekly R2 pivot point. That's a classic source of resistance. Today's high is just a half dozen pips above the daily M4 pivot point, another source of resistance. Today's high is also a baker's dozen pips below the 200 EMA on the daily chart, yet another prospective source of resistance. Here's my point. Traders who went long on the euro somewhere near the June lows or near today's low or anywhere in between all had reasons to close the trades for profit at or near one of the sources of resistance that I've just mentioned. Now, if you so choose, you may seek to profit from the profit taking from of others by planning and executing a plan to take a counter trend trade. In this case, the dominant trend today and dominant trend since early June has been up, so the counter trend trade would be a short. And as always, the ideal place to enter a short is at a level of resistance. As I mentioned just moments ago, the area around the weekly R2 pivot point has served as resistance previously today, so it's certainly possible it could do so again. Also, note that we had the makings here of a classic uptrend reversal pattern. I've just outlined the price action since London Open with red with a blue marker, and that looks like this price action looks like the left shoulder right here. I'll label with an L, the left shoulder and the head. Let's label the head with an H. Left shoulder and head of a head and shoulders pattern. One way to play a head and shoulders pattern is to short at or near the level defined by the top of the left shoulder, which in this case, there's the top of the left shoulder. In this case, that is at about 1.3240. So traders who were seeking to short this pair got their chance to do so about 15 minutes later. You can see here that the euro hesitated for several minutes in the 1.3240 area. 1.3240 right in there. So if you took the shot short, you're in the short trade at or near 1.3240. Stop loss initially positioned 50 pips above your entry for catastrophic protection purposes. And your exit strategy might be to close the trade for a modest loss if the euro makes a new high for the day. About 30 minutes later. And the euro is facing London session lows, which again, just right around here, but it's below 1.3220. At this point, you're about 15 pips in profit on the short trade, even with a less than perfect entry. Certainly reasonable at this point to move your stop loss to break even. A little more than 45 minutes later, the euro reaches a logical profit target for those traders who treated this as a counter trend scalp type trade. The idea is to close the short trade at a level where euro bulls might look to buy. Yesterday's high, just below 1.32, is one such level, a place where buyers might be lurking. If you close the short trade near the blue line on this chart, which represents yesterday's high, you earned about 40 pips on that short. And that was about as good as it got in the currency market today. At the London close, the euro was just 7 pips north of where it was at the New York session open. Pound dollar was literally flat on the session. I mean, literally, no change on pound dollar. And the net moves on the euro yen and pound yen currency pairs were less than 10 pips over the course of 4 hours. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Tuesday, August 3rd.